Hello, everybody. Goodbye, Keo here with people.
Did you say hello?
Yeah, I did.
Hello, Miss Obama.
Oh, what have I started?
Don't say that word in this room.
That's a dangerous word. So yes, let's go around the table as per usual.
Hello.
Oh my god.
I'm Caitlin, my character's Faye Noah Maple Rock.
I dare you to continue it.
I want to, but I'm laughing.
You got this.
Hello.
Oh my god.
I'm Mage, and I play Zumeli. Hello.
God.
Are we all doing this?
I'm Kat, and I play Mal.
Hello.
I'm Bumble, and I play Mav.
Hello, I'm Dignified, and I play Qualius Tawasil.
Yes!
Yes! Love it.
God. Hello, I'm Lantra, and I'm Dave. Mr. Obama, please.
Now we got...
And computer?
Oh yes, computer.
Hello!
Oh god.
No.
I'm Katie. And I play Kim.
What have I done? What have I... This is all on me.
Yeah.
Yes, it is.
So for sure, I'm not going to continue with that.
No.
Too much of a hassle.
But as you guys have... I know, like... By the first episode, you'd be like, oh yeah, that's the title, that's, like, no shit. But we finally figured it out in this time frame that we're gonna name this series Misfit Mayhem. Because look at our fucking group. We have a snake racist, a liberal arts elf, a barbarian awkward lizard man.
Dragon man.
We got a garbage thief who steals garbage. And then we have fucking...
Demon twins?
Demon twins, yes.
And a burb.
And a burb.
Large bird hippie.
Yes, bird hippie. That's it. What a group this is. All cursed to lose a limb.
Yay.
Except Koo.
Except Koo!
Koo is absolutely scot-free in this.
Yep.
Damn you.
You could even say she's free as a bird.
Oh, my god.
I appreciate that.
Of course you do.
But yeah, last we left off, the two tieflings who couldn't read went to the library and stole a book. So now we have these four, the thief, the snake, the lizard man, and the elf, are in the center square of town, where they are met with a bank, Safeways and Serpents, and a back alley that possibly is a shop? It's Sunday, so a lot of things are closed.
Mm. Okay, like, Qualius is very used to the experience of just, like, being put in a group and having to just be like, okay, we're working together now, let's, like, harmonize in whatever way that means. So he's immediately like, okay, so do we all wanna just go to each place together so we can, you know, have the broadest range of appeal, or do we wanna split up?
I say go to each place together, that way we have, like, the, like you said, the broadest range of appeal, and we have, like, four different opinions, like, what the person's saying, are they telling the truth, are they really, someone we should be talking to?
I like that a lot, and, you haven't really said much, sorry, I don't think I ever got your name, by the way.
Zumeli,
okay.
And I vote we go to Safeways and Serpents. Not because I'm biased or anything.
I mean,
either way, we'll just go to Safeway and Serpents. We'll get to all of them eventually.
Yeah, no reason not to start there.
Oh, alright,
okay, so we go to Safeways and Serpents.
Okay, you come in, the double doors open up, and you're instantly greeted with, "Hi, welcome to Safeways and Serpents! How can I help you today?"
Qualius just, like, immediately puts a hand up and is like, it's okay, you can relax, you don't need to, like, put on that much for us, it's okay, seriously.
That's okay, I'm here to help! You can realize she has little wings behind her, so she might be fairykin.
Ah.
That's just how she talks.
So, Dane steps up to the group, and he's like, we are looking for some sort of rock bird, and we would like some help. If you happen to have any information, it would be greatly appreciated.
Well, we do have potions that turn people into birds, and we do have pet rock companions, but I do not think we have a bird in the shape of a rock.
Hmm. Yeah, well, let's see, I don't think we're, like, getting a lot of... I don't think we're getting a lot out of this.
Do you have any serpents here?
We have many!
Can I use my, what's it called again?
You might just go...
Animal friendship for snakes only.
So you want to speak to the manager?
Yes.
Nice. Okay, yes. I'll go get the manager!
She titters away, just flutter, flutter. She walks on her tippy toes. She's flutter, flutter, flutter. And you wait for a while, you're just kind of there. You kind of move aside so people can come into the store, because it's an actual grocery store for magic.
Can Dave do a perception check to, like, see if there's a director or anything that would possibly hint at where he might get more clues to look for these rock bird eggs?
Yes.
Okay, what is that? Is that a 1d10? No.
Maybe a 1d20.
Yeah,
1d20.
I thought all of these kinds of rolls were 20s. Okay.
They should probably look for a pet section or a gourmet food section.
Hey, let us mess this up on our own.
So, that's like this plus my perception, right? So 17.
Do you roll a 17?
I rolled a 17. Well, I got 16 and then plus my perception, which is plus 1.
So yeah, you look at the directory and you see a section for eggs. You see a section about rocks, like... decorative garden rocks for those who like to go outside and stuff. You see a section for like crystals and stuff. You see like bird items, but nothing about a rock bird that you're looking for.
Okay. Qualius is still just like standing waiting for the person to come back. Hasn't really thought to like check. Like noticed Dave went over somewhere, but like, yep.
Oh wait. In my perception check, is like, could I notice, like, are there also, like, book? Can I just ask the question? Are there, like, a magical book section, you know what I mean? Or is it just,
no, just magazines.
Items? Okay.
Yeah, it's like a Winko. Mm-hmm. But eventually, you hear some click-clacks of some heels come by. Ooh. And you hear I heard someone was searching for me. Yes. Turn around. There's a Gorgon. With shades on, she looks like a really classy businesswoman. Like, you know, blinder shades, because obviously. Mm-hmm. And her hair is just going like wiggling a little, but it's in a fairly nice do. Uh-huh. It kind of looks like curls a little bit. She's kind of looking and just like, what you want?
So is the Gorgon wearing a veil?
Well, I guess, like the medieval equivalent of sunglasses, in a way. Like, maybe like a blindfold or something.
In that case, would my animal friendship still work in this case?
She's got snakes in her hair.
Yeah, that's why I'm like, because it's like a person, but there's also like, snakes are involved. So
yeah, like her hair would be on your side.
Yeah, okay.
That's such a weird
bad hair day.
What?
The snakes are on your side. Just give her a bad hair day.
But fellow snakes.
Give her a
camaraderie,
bad hair.
Man.
Give her a bad hair day.
Like, oh,
this is so
you.
Entertainingly awkward.
So I guess basically just turn to the Gorgon and just, have you heard of this rock bird? We're searching for one.
What sort of rock bird? Do you mean a crystallized sort of Articuno bird, or what do you have in mind?
Unfortunately, I don't believe we have this information. Yes, we don't have specifics.
Like the name of the bird is rock.
Yes,
that's what I've been able to parse out so far.
So it is not a earthian rock, but a bird named one. Well, she thinks, she rubs her chin a bit, and her hair bun, which is, again, like, up in curls, starts to curl a little bit and go down like she's, like, her hair literally undid itself to go long down. Mm-hmm. And her snakes are going to her, and she's like, mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm. Okay. So, I can't help you here. We don't have any sort of things like that. We don't branch out to the exotic products very often, and that is a very exotic product. However, there is an exotic magic shop that just opened up down the way. Like, go north a little bit. It's in an alley. Some of our employees have been getting some things from there, so that's how I mostly know about it. She has very good conditioner. She rubs her snake scales a bit, and they go... So that would be your best bet. I'm sorry we can't... can I interest you in you purchasing something else here, perhaps? Like a map set? Some health potions, if you're looking for this rock? Maybe metal?
Oh man, if anybody, like, has some actual money on them, wouldn't hurt to get, like... I don't know, if we're gonna have to meet a big bird, we want to be prepared for that, I guess.
Yes. How many of us have explorer packs?
I have an explorer pack.
Because I do as well.
I have an entertainer pack.
I have a burglar's pack.
Oh, you... Oh, okay. Okay.
So notice how the health potion's doing.
I have 3 costumes total.
I have no idea what's in my burglar's pack.
Yeah, you'd want to look that up right now?
Yes.
Because right now I have a dagger, arcane focus, the explorer's pack, which is the backpack, bedroll, mess kit, tinderbox, 10 torches, 10 days rations, water skin, and 50 feet of rope, then a spell book, a set of fine clothes, a signet ring, and a scroll of pedigree, which that's just like noble stuff.
Yeah.
And then now I have 12 gold because of the thing from earlier.
I can't believe you did that.
I'm sorry, the money was stupid.
I'm sorry, it's gonna be tomorrow and I'm still not gonna be over that. Also,
sorry.
Help me, I don't know where to find it.
Sorry, I started eating a cracker because I thought they were going to talk more, but now they're looking at a book.
Exactly.
I was mostly just like listening off what I had so we could figure out if we wanted to buy anything.
I'm trying to figure out what I have.
Okay, well, while you guys are chatting amongst yourselves, Qualius turns to the Gorgon and is like, you know, we'll look around, see.
Call me Medi. Hmm? It's like, instead of saying just Gorgon, I just call me Miss Medi.
Sure, sure. Miss Medi, thank you so much for, talking to us. We'll just look around, and thank you for the info, actually.
Okay.
That's really helpful.
I officially know it's in my bag.
Okay, cool.
In a burglar's pack, I have a backpack, a bag of 1,000 ball bearings, 10 feet of string, a bell, 5 candles, a crowbar, a hammer, 10 pittons, a hooded lantern, 2 flasks of oil, 5 days rations, so I didn't need those 10 biscuits, but I have 10 biscuits.
Yeah.
A tinder box, and a water skin.
You also have 16 gold.
Ooh, yeah, that's 16 gold. The pack also has 50 feet of hempen rope strapped to the side of it.
Now that you mentioned that, I'm tempted to give myself a chocolate croissant, because I probably stuck one in my bag before we headed out.
Never know when you need it.
Chocolate. That's not how you spell chocolate.
Spell chocolate however you want.
Yeah. Free country, USA.
It's fantasy chocolate. You can spell
fantasy
it however you
chocolate.
Want.
Still better than the two who can't read.
I see you over there, Lantra, making them references.
Yeah, no, we're...
Please, no, not on here. Oh, no.
Hey, none of that was hearable, so we're good.
As far as we know.
Yeah, anyway. all of that was out of character.
Yes.
So, who did what exactly?
Well, basically, like... all of that stuff is out of character. So Qualius just talked to Miss Meddy and was like, hey, thank you for the service. We're going to look around. So then we got sidetracked with what's in a burglar's pack. So, yeah, thank you. We'll look around. How did Meddy respond?
Yeah.
I'm just like, welcome. You know, it's nice to help fellow snakes, fellow serpents of the title.
Mm-hmm. Sweet. All right.
Because, you know, Safeways have membership cards. Serpents already get one.
Hell yes.
So you're noble. Do you need a membership card?
I need a membership to everything.
Well, you're a noble family. You probably already have one.
Yeah, probably.
Qualius misinterpreted the phrase serpents of the title and now feels weird that he got snubbed for the fancy snake lady.
Dave's just here. He's kind of just looking around like, these people are having a moment and I'm not going to bother them.
I'm looking at their lunch section and wondering, is it worth it to try and see if I can steal a sandwich, unwrap it, and walk out? I paid for this sandwich, you know, maybe all stealth or sleight of hand like.
Please don't anger the Gorgon.
Do you know what I'm actually doing and wondering,
thinking in my head, mm-hmm. not saying my thoughts aloud. I don't have a 11 intelligence.
You actually are the smartest
one of us. I don't need this
from
you. Yeah, exactly. That's why I'm only thinking it. I'm not actually doing it.
I don't need this from you.
You're getting it from me.
So is there a place with, like, an aisle with, like, health potions and stuff? Is that, like,
Yeah.
Okay, so Dave starts heading down that way, because I don't think he has anything of that nature, and he probably wants one.
Qualius follows Dave.
Okay.
Okay, so how much is a health potion? Like a basic standard one?
A lot. There should be most of the equipment, right? Or like in here somewhere?
It's 50 GP.
Okay, never mind.
Oh, Jesus.
Dave looks at one, puts it back, and makes a face at Qualius and just shakes his head.
But no, no, no. This is Safeway. It's a nice 5 GP.
Oh. Oh man, getting that store brand.
Yeah.
With or without the membership.
Also, can't you guys haggle?
That's with.
Okay. Well, I mean, but we could if we wanted to.
That's true.
Again, let us make our own mistakes.
Okay, so.
Don't let this one haggle.
What? Yeah, don't let the noble serpent haggle. 50 GP!
I'm sorry. Mage did a derp. Zumeli is not supposed to be that dumb.
Well, hey, she's the one with the membership card here.
Yup.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
Oh, so then, okay, so
oh,
Dave.
Oh, man, yeah. Then,
yeah,
then
Dave calls over Zumeli and just like, so can you get us a possible discount because you have a membership?
Will you be paying for it yourself?
Yes, as long as you flash your card.
Okay, that's fine with
Wait.
Me. Wait,
and then he pauses because he's like, is that the right thing to do?
Oh no!
And he's like, never mind.
Yeah, Qualius is just like puts a hand on his bicep and is like, man, come on, you already said you were going to pay the money. There's nothing under the table going on.
Yeah, it's like, Okay. So then he does end up taking one. So I guess I should just turn my 10 GP into 5 GP?
Yeah.
If I want to buy one? Okay.
Why not?
Oh, geez, I had more gold than you?
Yeah,
oh,
man, of course. I am poor as fuck.
You should probably put that in your items if you have a Safeway card.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Or more specifically, a serpent card.
Or does your pedigree just work for this?
That's part of it. You have a pedigree of like, hey, I'm an actual Naga. Here's your card. It's like the old days when they mailed you a, like, registration card of, like, con. Of, like, there's a whole letter, and then your card's attached to the bottom with, like, glue. That's your Safeway card. Like, that's your pedigree. And then the card at the bottom.
That would not surprise me at all. Just, like, give all of you aunties this.
Okay, that's everything in my bag.
You turned 18. Here's a Safeway card.
Nice.
Rite of passage. All right,
cool.
Rite of passage.
I have not completed that rite of passage.
All right, so is there anything else we want to do here, or do we want to move over to that magic shop that the lady was talking about?
I wonder if anyone of us the group needs a map, because that was listed in one of the things.
Ooh, not bad thinking. So we head over to the map section.
Mm-hmm. Hey, what maps do you want?
What maps are there?
Well, we have one of the city, we have some of the mountain ranges and stuff.
Like
surrounding there, and some just of the continent state we're in.
I'm trying to figure out which skill would be used to, like, look at all of them and see, like, if anything stands out as, like yeah, that could help us if we're heading out.
Into the west, right?
Yeah.
We're going to the west.
Yeah, so what should I roll to see if I find any maps that are relevant to us?
D20.
What's my modifier?
Would that be, like, wisdom?
Yeah, would that be wisdom?
I'd add wisdom.
Okay.
So, just add wisdom to it.
Shit, where is my... Okay, there's my, wisdom modifier. Or wait, no, it'd be like, would that be insight, or perception, or...
Maybe perception.
Oh, right. Awesome, that's a better one for me. Okay, so, checking to see if there's any maps that would be, like, really handy for us... 19 plus 3, 22.
Yeah, you definitely got it.
Nice.
It literally says Western Mountains on it, and you're like, hey, look at this one.
Nice.
Nice going.
How much is it?
Oh,
with
true.
The membership card.
Membership discount.
Percentage dice.
Hey.
Let's see. Ow. Sorry. So, they're having a sale today.
Ooh.
So, it is originally 10, but it's 70% off. So, you get it for 3 gold.
Oh, wow. Man.
Nice.
I've got this one. I've totally got this one. You show your card, I give you the 3 gold.
Okay.
Yeah, it's good to have the snake lady.
Hell yeah, it is.
All right, so that puts me down to 12 gold. And I do you want me to hold the map, or should someone else hold the map? Like, Dave, do you want to hold the map?
No, you can hold the map. Okay. It's fine.
Can I grab the eraser from you, Landra? If you still have it
somewhere?
Yeah. Yeah.
There
it is.
Whee!
Good catch.
Hell yeah. I have 15
gold
now.
Nice.
Okay, so, we have... a healing potion. We have the map. Anything else?
So the aisles are, so far you've said, one for rocks, one for birds, one for potions, one
for
maps.
Well, again, they can go to the grocery store. Whatever you can think of, just ask. They'll probably have it.
Okay.
It's not like Costco, but...
Yeah,
it's bargain shit.
Well, okay. No, Safeway is actually one of the more expensive standard grocery stores. Like, from my experience, Safeway tends to be more expensive than Fred Meyer.
Yeah.
Still shitty.
It's still a grocery store.
How about looking?
Yeah.
Well, that's just...
I am not supposed to speak.
What?
What?
You're not, she's not there, so she can't...
Oh, not yeah, there. you're not there. Okay, so... do we want to grab anything else while we're here, or do we want to head over?
I literally got rid of 50% of my gold, so I'm a little bit wary about buying anything else, but if anybody else wants to go and explore, Dave's up for chaperoning.
Yeah, and Qualius isn't, you know, too eager to spend money that they don't have to, so it's like, I think we're good, so if you two are ready to head out, then
we have two other places to visit, so...
Yeah.
Exactly.
We only have half a day, so we shouldn't be like,
right.
Montage shopping spree.
Yeah, exactly. So, we head over to the alley that we were told about.
Alright. So you go to the back alley where you saw the overhead awning thing and the candles there. And yeah, it's like completely deserted other than the shop here. And you smell like a really sweet scent coming out of it. Like some sort, like you think it's incense, but it's much too sweet. Like it's almost like a candle, but it also has that smoky edge to it. You don't know what it is, but it just smells really nice. So you find your way in. It's a typical magic shop. You got some potions here and there. You got like some jewelry hanging here and there with some sigils on it. You got some skulls. For your skull ritual needs.
Mm-hmm.
And as you come in, a little bell that's hanging there goes ding-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling because to signal you there. There's no door, but you just kind of knock into it naturally. And you hear a, I'll be right there! And you hear a,
boy, Foley work.
Mm-hmm. You're not sure what the hell's happening, and you think you hear a goat.
I'm writing that down. Goat question mark.
Yeah. And then out comes this girl who looks around like 16, 15.
Huh.
And she has her hair up in like a bow. Like, it's really interesting looking. And she's like dressed in like this pink and gold sort of like Chinese inspired outfit with like harem pants that are white.
Hmm.
And she's like, oh, hi, how can I help you? No one's been here for so long. Hi. She just goes up to the counter being like, hi. Waves excitedly.
Okay, before Qualius steps in, I did want to ask, like, would any of your guys' characters immediately step in to talk, or would Qualius just, like, is Qualius free to just, like, immediately step in and start chatting?
Dave or Qualius, really, I can
imagine. No, yeah, Zumali is definitely, like, more antisocial. She would really want to interact with people if she can help it.
So, we're in this shop. This person has just come up. Do you think that Dave would immediately go into...
Dave would probably definitely feel like that, like, kinship of kind of, like, being awkward and just, like, being really, like, wanting to please and just, like, this kind of, like, you know, like, if it's a person of the town, he wants to talk to them. If he was in a bar, he'd be like, I don't know about this, but, like, you know, it's, like,
okay.
One of the town
people. Then, yeah, let's have Dave do it.
So Dave, like, comes up to the counter with a nice grin, which is a little bit toothy. Element. So he's like, hello, what is your name? My name is Dave. I'm actually here to look, inquire about a rock. Is that right, Qualis?
Yeah,
rock,
yeah, yeah.
Egg, but it's a rock bird egg. I'm sorry, I hope I'm making sense.
Yes, we're looking for the egg of a rock.
The yolk of
That's
an egg
it.
Of a rock.
That's it.
She looks at you guys just trying to process it. Like, think of that meme of, like, calculating.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
She does that for a moment. Like, internal internet dial-up sounds. She's like that for a moment. She kind of just kind of snaps out of it, though. She's like, oh, yes? I'm Kayrin. By the way, hi. Why do you need a rock egg?
That is great, Kayrin. I just happen to need. We need to have the yolk for
breakfast tomorrow morning.
No. Yes.
No.
We're very fascinated by certain species, and we are looking for... Help me, Qualius. We are looking for this...
Qualius sees that all of this is going to shit, and is internally like, okay, I was hoping to save my spell slots till later, but I guess might as well. Casts Charm Person. Let's see. Let's see, I need to look up what the details of that are.
Charm person
5e. I found it!
Okay.
Okay. So, and my phone died! Read me off the details.
Your phone.
I do. Read me off the details of Charm Person.
You attempt to charm a humanoid you can see within range and must make a wisdom saving throw and does so with advantage if you or your companions are fighting it. If it fails the saving throw, it is charmed by you until the spell ends or until you or your companions do anything harmful to it. The charmed creature regards you as a friendly acquaintance. When the spell ends, the creature knows it was charmed by you.
And
the duration is an hour.
And it's, they're rolling against my charisma, right? Or...
They're rolling against your spell save DC.
Oh, how do I find
eight
that?
Plus your proficiency, so 10 plus your wisdom modifier.
So 10 plus my wisdom modifier?
Yeah. So it'll be 11.
Oh, okay, 11.
Okay,
so
I gotta beat 11.
Yeah, I guess so.
Alright, let's
see. Or it might be your charisma.
That's what I was thinking. Okay, I thought charm person was charisma, because you're charming them.
Well, right. Charm person, because you're a bard, it's your charisma.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. So yeah, in that 14. Case, 10 plus 4, so 14, so...
Okay, gotta beat a 14.
Write that.
Yeah.
On the other side
there.
Of her. Let's go. Whoop, whoop. 6.
Nice.
Oh, okay.
Oh, it is right there. Okay. So it is 14. Yeah. And yeah, my spellcasting ability is... Oh, okay, so that is all written right there. Learning. Okay, so... how does, like, now that, you
how
know,
do you want to charm her?
Oh, I didn't even think of that. Okay, so, yeah. So, Qualius comes up and is like, hey, so we're kind of, like, on a quest right now. We need to pay off a debt, and, the person that we're questing for needed the yolk from an egg from a rock. Like, and I guess the rock is a name of a bird. So we were just really hoping we could get any information we could about rocks or their eggs. Like, we have an idea of where it might be, but any info you could give us on that would be great, too.
Like, if you're casting the spell, are you, like, playing an instrument to, like, cast it, or...
Oh my god, Okay, rewind.
Yeah,
take two.
I was thinking you were gonna serenade her and, like, have a spell that
yeah.
way.
Yeah, rewind, take two. Second draft. I love this. Okay, so seeing that everybody else is kind of not doing great on the charisma front, Qualius brings out his lyre and just starts like plinging a little like ding 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 ding. Hey, and it just, like, keeps doing that little...
Hey, girl.
Yeah, and just, like, while strumming that same little thing, just goes, like, pretty much the same spiel as before. Hey, we're doing a quest right now. The person that we're questing for needs the yolk of an egg, of a rock. And, like, we have a vague idea of where it is, but if you could give us any details on that, or how to approach a rock, or anything about them, that'd be awesome. Ding, 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 ding.
And
ding,
as you're
ding.
Playing it, she's kind of swaying back and forth of, like, the music really is captivating her. She's like, ah, oh, yeah, that's nice. She's not saying it out loud,
yeah,
but
yeah.
She has that vibe of, like, ah, oh, that's nice. That's real good. And she's like, yeah, I can help you.
Yeah, awesome. So, what's up? Like, what do you have about
what's
rocks?
What's up, girl?
Give me a moment. Stay here. She goes in the back. You hear more scuttle, scuttle, scuttle.
The goat.
A box tipping over. A horse.
Write that down.
Horse?
Write it down too.
I like this idea that Dave has a little notebook that he's keeping.
Oh, he totally. He's just like, horse? Question mark?
Someday we need to just see Dave's notebook. Goat? Horse?
Macaulay just looks just like, horse, goat, gorgon.
But that is where we need to leave off.
Okay.
Yay!
So next time we're going to see how Kayrin helps our fine folk here.
Yeah!
Woo! Woo!
And charming elf.
Yeah!
Hey, girl.
Ding, ding, ding.
Like,
ding,
see, that's the thing is, it ended up coming out sort of like western-y. Ding, 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 ding. But
I thought it sounded, like, pretty. Of, like,
well,
just, like,
that's because it was supposed to be into the woods, because it was the first thing that came into my mind. Yeah. It's that little melody that's throughout so many parts of Into the Woods.
Yeah.
So yeah, anyway.
Yeah, so next time, more help! Yay!
Woo!
Rock,
woo!
We're definitely on our way.
Yeah.
Yeah. So have a good day, everybody. Bye!
Bye!
The demons are on their phone the whole time.
Hey, that's just how it be sometimes.
Yeah, I just like, you guys are done at the library,
yeah.
So you're just like on your phones. You're
or
looking
whatever
glasses.
The equivalent, yeah.